Japan! I knew I'd have to do that sooner or later. Anyway, guys, it is 7:23 a.m. here in Shizuoka, and I am on my way to work. It's Saturday morning. Ugh. All right, the pool story, why I quit playing pool. Okay, to give you guys a little background, every prefecture in Japan has a billiards association and a billiards club. And the billiards club is actually inside of the billiards association. So they work together, and the leader of the billiards association is basically the top dog in both. Okay, only here in Shizuoka Prefecture, they were separate. The association did their thing, and the club did their thing. Now, the reason for that was that the leader of the association and the leader of the club did not get along. So the club split off on its own and didn't have any outside support from the association. Now, I belong to the club, and from 96 to about 99, I was ranked number one here in Shizuoka Prefecture. You would think that the association would have more power than the club, but actually here in Shizuoka, the club had more power than the association. When the All Japan tournaments would come up, it was the club that sent people, it wasn't the association. Anyway, so I belonged to the club, and I didn't have an official position, per se, but the leader of the club always included me in meetings and stuff like that. Well, anyway, at the end of 99, in December of 1999, Shizuoka had decided to merge the club and the association. And one of the stipulations to that was that the leader of the club would step down. Well, I don't think it was a smooth transition to begin with. When they had the meeting, the leader of the club called me and Tomoko, and he said, "Would you guys come with me to this meeting?" So we're like, "Yeah, of course." So, you know, we went to the meeting, blah, 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 blah. And it came down to that he was going to, you know, resign his position as the leader of the club, and the association would take over everything. Well, he was basically forced out, and I didn't really appreciate that very much. So I had considered quitting the club because I didn't want to support the association. But he told me that I should continue playing and, you know, blah, 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 blah. So I decided to stay. Well, come February, now remember, this was in December when we had the meeting. Come February, February is when they start collecting the players for the All Japan tournament. Well, the way they select the players for the Japan tournament, if I remember correctly, my God, it's been so long. The first and second ranked players, and then the person that won the final tournament in December, and then two people that the club sponsors to go. So anyway, I was ranked number one, and they were getting the names together to go to the All Japan tournament in May, and the name list came out, and my name wasn't on it, and I was like, "What? That's not right." So I called I called the association, and I talked to the top guy, and he's an older guy, probably in his 60s at the time, and I said to him, I said, I think you guys made a mistake. I'm not on the list for the All Japan tournament. And he said, you're not going. And I said, why not? He said, you're a foreigner. He said, we can't have foreigners representing the prefecture. Yeah, so there's your racism in Japan. Discrimination, if you will. Well, needless to say, that pissed me off to no end. I had been to the All Japan tournament previously 4 or 5 times as the ranked number one player and as a sponsored player from the club. But yeah, he flat out said straight that you can't go because you're a foreigner, and we don't want foreigners representing the prefecture. So this got around, and the of course he's not, you know, I mean he's the leader, but of course there's a board, and the board got wind of this. And they climbed all over him. I mean, they really went in on my defense and said, look, you can't do this. He's the number one ranked player. He's got to go. You know, and, you know, you can't do that. That's, you know, total discrimination is basically what they said. It's sabetsu. And they got it turned around to where I could go. And, you know, I kind of felt sorry for the person that got kicked out. But that spot was rightfully mine. So they got it turned around that I could go to the tournament, but by the time they got it turned around, which is probably like a week or so later, I don't remember how long it was, by the time they got it fixed, the damage was done. I was too mad just over the thought that that kind of thing could happen in something like playing pool. So I refused to go, and I told him, you know, I'm just, you know, leave it the way it is, I'm not going. And I told him I quit. I'm not joining the association, I'm not joining their tournaments, I'm not supporting them in any way, shape, or form, and I'm done. And I quit the league, quit the association, quit the club, quit everything. But that really put a really, really sour taste in my mouth, and I didn't play pool for almost 5 years after that. Didn't even go into a pool hall. Had no interest to go in. Had no drive. And to give you guys an idea, at that time, I was playing every day, probably 3, 4, 5 hours every day, longer on the weekends. I would finish work at, you know, 8 o'clock at night, and I'd go to the pool hall, and I'd stay there until 1 o'clock in the morning, shooting pool. Pool was my life. That's all I did was shoot pool in my free time. And, you know, I traveled to America. Well, we were on a trip, and I got into tournaments in Las Vegas. I got into a tournament in Cincinnati. I actually got into a tournament in Cincinnati and beat one of the local pros in the final match, and I won the tournament. And that was funny because American pool players all have, you know, really pissy attitudes, and for some reason, I don't know why, but American pool players cannot accept losing. And you know, the thing is, when you're shooting pool, everybody loses. You cannot win every game. And the guy that I beat at that tournament, I'll admit he's a better player than me, but I'm not so bad that I can't beat him. I mean, come on, I was playing at that level too. But if I would say if we played for a long time, you know, months, years, it would average out that he would be winning over me. And, you know, I admit that, but I beat him at that tournament, and I won, I don't know, $300 or $400, I don't remember how much it was, won a couple hundred dollars, and, the first thing he did, instead of congratulating me on the win or shaking my hand or anything like that, he got pissed off and he said that he wanted to play me for the money that I had just won in the tournament. So I told him, I'm sorry, that's not going to happen. And I broke down my cue and I left. But, you know, anyway, pool was my life. And, you know, I grew up playing pool. We had a pool table at home. And, you know, I basically lived in the pool room when I was a teenager. And I got over here and, you know, the first day, the day I got off the plane, I got settled in at my new place. And the first thing I did was grabbed a phone book and went looking for a pool hall. And the next day I was at a pool hall. And just a little side note here. If anybody's ever seen my band on the Fulcher 33 channel, the bass player is actually a friend of mine from the pool hall, and I've met him like very early after I got here in Japan, so I've known him for as long as I've been here. But anyway, so I didn't shoot pool for like 5 years, and it was at such a point that I sold my cue, I sold my case, I sold everything that I had related to pool, except for my brake cue. I don't know why I didn't sell that. I still have that brake cue. But anyway, I didn't play for a couple years, about 5 years, and then a new pool hall opened near my old apartment, just before Tomoko and I got married. This new pool hall opened, and I went down there. While they were just putting the finishing touches on it. The place hadn't opened yet. So I went in, you know, checked the place out and talked to the owner. And then I thought, well, you know, it's close to the house and I don't have any obligations to get involved in anything with the tournament, with the association. And I had spoken to him about the association before, and he said that his room wasn't going to join it. So I was like, cool. So I went back. I started playing pool again. Not as hardcore as I used to, but I figured I would go down every once in a while and shoot some pool and, you know, try to get my stroke back. And I ordered a cue from my favorite cue maker in the States. His name's Paul Motti. And for people that don't play pool, custom pool cues can be very costly. Mine was $2,200. So I ordered the cue, and it was a custom order, so he had to make it, and it was going to take like a year and a half, something like that. So I figured I would go shoot, you know, every week or so, maybe a couple days a week, just for a little bit of fun, and then maybe get back into playing seriously when my cue got here. Well, the cue got here, and I never did get back to playing seriously. I had, you know, there were a couple times I had considered joining the association again, because I've never been a gambler with pool. I'm a tournament player. I love playing tournaments. I've got a box full of trophies at home. I should get those out and put them up somewhere. Sorry, I'm going to sneeze. always come in twos. So I was always a tournament player, and at one point I had considered joining the association again and getting back into the tournaments, but I just couldn't support him. I could not support that guy running the show. Now I have heard that he is retired and doesn't have anything to do with it anymore. But it's been so long now that I just don't have the discipline to go back in and get into pool shape, you know, getting used to shooting again the way I used to. If you're not a pool, I mean, I can still play, of course. I play all right, but I'm not in tournament condition. You know, I miss miss too many shots. And by missing too many shots, that's like missing one. You know, you miss one shot, the game's over. So I'm not in the condition to play like that anymore. But, that's why I quit playing pool, because, you know, he blatantly said, you're a foreigner, you can't go to the All Japan tournament, even though I'd been there 5 times before. He must have been smoking in his boots in the previous years when I was going. I never did get along with the guy, even before that. He always seemed like a two-faced butt wipe to me. But, you know, I didn't have anything. I wasn't, you know, related to him in any way, shape, or form. So the only time I had to see him was, like, if a new pool hall was opening and everybody would show up and he would be there, blah, blah, blah. But other than that, I never had to really deal with him, so I didn't really give him too much mind. But I had no idea that his assholeness was because I'm a round eye. All right, well, there you go, guys. That is the story. 17 minutes of just blather. I hope I didn't bore you. And you guys have a great weekend, and we'll catch you later. Don't let your meat loaf.